Do forgive one's attire, one has not long been out of the shower. I got this. Patum Peperium? I think that's how it's pronounced. It says the gentleman's relish. Established 1828. Delicious on hot toast. I have never had toast that has been hot. It's, by the time it's got into one's mouth, it tends to be just very warm. I had keeping the accent up. Perfect spread on toast, crackers, or blinis. It's a salted anchovies and butter, rusk, water, raisin agent, may contain gluten. See ingredients in bold. Store in a cool, dry place. It's been in the fridge. Once opened, keep refrigerated and use within 4 weeks. Salt crystals may form naturally on this product. The toast's already in the toaster. I should have read this up. I don't know how to get into this. And I don't want my toast to burn. If my toast burns, I shall make some more. How the hell do you get into this? Do you twist? Do you pull it? I don't know. Do you peel the label off? I got it from Sainsbury's. Oh, you got to peel the label off like this. So it's like inside, just stick the sticker to the pole. Oh, and it's extra sealed. To appreciate the fine flavour of this relish, it should be used very sparingly in bold letters. If you would like some recipe leaflets or have any questions, please return this slip. Okay. Gentleman's relish, it's salty as well, which makes all sorts of connotations, doesn't it? Oh, it's not what I expected. Oh my god, it smells of fish food. It actually smells of fish flakes, and I know it smells like fish flakes because I have smelt them and eaten them when I used to have an aquarium. Let's get a bit on a knife and see how this tastes. That's my toaster just popped. Wow, whoa! That is salty. Oh, wow! They are kidding! Flipping hell, can use this sparingly. I'm just gonna get someone some toast now. Hang on a minute. Well, as I was spreading it like a numpty, I totally forgot on that slice and I've slathered it on like it was peanut butter or cheese. And then on the crusty bit, I've just put a very tiny bit on. Oh, fucking hell, that is salty. I thought anchovies were salty already, and these are salted anchovies. Oh. Right, well, first of all, for the smell. If you want to know what it smells like, and you don't want to buy this stuff first, just smell some fish food. The consistency, and that lot, it's sort of got the slightest essence of it being like, you know, like Brussels pate? I love pate on toast. Just the best, innit? I love pate on toast. Has to be Brussels, though. I don't like sardines. Oh, flipping heck. You can feel the salt just dissolving on your tongue. I love anchovies. I love anchovies, but this. All right, I've loaded it on, but oh, it's just salt. It doesn't, it's not like anchovies at all. Oh, it's so salty. My tongue is burning. Oh, this is, I'm salivating so much. It's a bit like when I drank out of Robinson's fruit juice, the ones in the squashed little bottles on its own. My tongue is burning. My fucking tongue's on fucking fire. Delicious on a hot toast. What a lie! What did you use this for? Is it just a joke? Come home and taste my
gentleman's salty relish.
And then if it turns out you don't like the person you've brought home, you just whip some of this out and serve it on toast. Established 1828. I don't like this at all. If you like incredibly, incredibly salty things, so much salty than anything you can ever think of, even saltier than salt, get this. You'll find it delicious. My eyes are watering, I've just realised. My eyes are actually watering at the saltiness. Nothing makes me do that. That is vile.